Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. We are going to solve extractive questions of GATE 2011. Let us see the first question. Humidification of the blast in the iron blast furnace leads to. Okay, so the question is asking about this humidification. Humidification means we are adding some amount of moisture. Moisture in the form of, that is H2O, right? Okay, so what are the options? Like lowering of the raceway temperature, increase in raceway temperature, difficulty in pulverized coal injection, decrease of the oxygen content in the hot metal. Okay, so what is the correct option for this? The correct option is lowering of the raceway temperature, right? This is a typical blast furnace which looks like this. Okay, and here is the position of this, your 2 years. Okay, and there is a burning which happens here. So this burning takes place in a circumferential way, right? So all the burners are there, like the 2 years are there. So the temperature which is attained over here, okay, that will decrease if we do the humidification of the blast. Okay, there is no point of increase in raceway temperature, no difficulty in pulverized coal injection, because coal is injected, you know, coal is injected through this one method, that is called as the metallurgical coke. Okay, and the option C, if you see, decrease of the oxygen content in the hot blast. So this is also not the correct option. Let us move to the next question. Which one of the following refractory material is not used in BOF LD working line? BOF means basic oxygen furnace, right? If you don't know the this full form, then you can see from here. LD, yeah, I think you know everyone. Okay, so this BOF LD, that means in the steel making process. So what is the basicity over here? So basicity is basically more than one, that means it is basic in nature. The slag is basic in nature. Okay, since the slag is basic in nature, now suppose this is a container, okay, and there is a slag and it is basic. This is basic, right? Now suppose you keep this lining as acidic, then there will be acid-base reaction. So that's why we have to keep a lining which is also basic. So which one of these is basic? Tar bonded dolomite. Yes, it contains dolomite. Okay, then next it is pitch bonded magnesite, fired and pitch impregnated magnesite, and graphite alumina composite. Okay, so see, so here it is asking that which one is not used. So this dolomite contains MgO, right? So this is basic, so this can be used. Pitch bonded magnesite, right, magnesite is also basic, so this can be used. Then fired and pitch impregnated magnesite, this can also be used. Graphite alumina composite, see here it contains alumina, that is Al2O3. So Al2O3 acts as slightly acidic, so this is not going to be, sorry guys. Next question. VOD process is preferred over AOD process for making extra low carbon stainless steel because, see, if you know the name of this VOD, then it is vacuum oxygen decarburization. And AOD सेम, दिस इज ऑल्सो डीकार्बोनाइजेशन बट आर्गन इज पुट ओवर. सो आर्गन इज यूज टू डिक्रीज द प्रेशर एंड हियर सिंस इट इज ऑलरेडी वैक्यूम सो देर इज फर्दर डिक्रीज इन द प्रेशर. ओके, सो दैट हेल्प्स इन रिडक्शन ऑफ बेसिकली रिमूवल ऑफ दिस कार्बन. सो हाउ डज इट रिमूव, लाइक सी प्लस हाफ ओ टू इट गिव्स सी यू. सो दिस इज इन गैस एंड सी यू इज ऑल्सो ए गैस. Let suppose there is a reaction which is happening, so CO will get out. So if the CO will get out, if you do not allow this easy escape of this CO, that means the partial pressure, if you do not keep it in a decreased manner, so what happens, there will a pressure increase because of this CO accumulation. So once pressure here it will increase, so this reaction will be in the backward direction, right? So for a better reaction we should have very low pressure as we want to have. So among this, which one is going to have lower pressure? VOD or AOD? Absolutely VOD, right? So that's what it is. Let us see from the option. PCO can be lowered to a much lower level in the VOD than in the AOD. Yes, so this looks the correct answer. Let us see other options also. AOD does not have adequate steering. No, it has steering. Free board needed for such operation is not available in the AOD. Yes, it is available. AOD refractory not stable in contact with extra low carbon. These are not so true. Okay, let us move on. In froth flotation, collector refers to a reagent which primarily, see what are the options, promotes bubble breakup and stabilizes the foam, adsorbs on the surface of the mineral and makes it hydrophobic. Yes, option B it is. So this is the use of the collector, that is genthet, right? Some genthet it is used. So what does it do? Like suppose this is your water and you have put mineral like particle. Okay, so this is a solid particle and initially it is wetted by liquid, right? So what happens here, the genthet, you know, potassium genthet or some kind of genthet is used. So this genthet gets attached to this particle, and this when it gets attached, then it becomes repellent of water. That means it becomes hydrophobic. So that's why it does not get wet with this water and it floats out. Okay, promote separation, see option C, promote separation of the particle from the float. No, adsorbs on the unwanted mineral and makes it sink. No. Okay, let us move on. Match the metals in group 1 with the corresponding ores in group 2. Okay guys, so this is easy question also, and this is such kind of question where you can remember the different ores also, you can test your memory, right? So options are like lead, zinc, uranium and niobium. So first you see, you will have to see the name of the ore and accordingly you can match it, right? So first it is columbite, right? See, the trick is that if it is written like columbite, no, this will be a ore of niobium, because the niobium is a new name, older one. In the older times it was called as columbium. Okay, so from there only the ore of name has also come, this columbite. So if you see the formula of this, I have written the formula also, I found it in the book. So it is Fe Mn niobium tantalum 206. This is the formula. Then cassiterite. So cassiterite is an ore of tin and the formula is SnO2. Remember this one, cassiterite. So terite means tin, so the name of tin has come, so you can remember like this, cassiterite, T. Okay, so tin. Galena, I think everyone knows it is PbS. Okay, galena is a famous ore of lead. Okay, lead. Pitchblende. I know you must have heard this name, and the formula for this pitchblende is U3O8, means ore of uranium. Sphalerite. So sphalerite is an ore of zinc, and it is sulfide or ZnS. Okay, so lead will match with galena, zinc will match with sphalerite, uranium will match with pitchblende, and niobium will match with your columbite. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, so secondly, you can see like 3, 5, 4, right? 3, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, and S1. Okay, so see next. Yeah, these two are very important questions. Okay, see, in an ideal blast furnace, the input and output are as follows. Input is ore, pure Fe2O3, no gang. Okay, so it is pure Fe2O3 and there is no gang. That means no impurity. Coke, it has pure carbon and no ash. That means it is also pure. Blast air and it is dry, and the composition is like O2, 293 kg per ton of hot metal and N2. Okay. Then flux, nil. We do not add any flux over here. Output is hot metal, which contains 58% of carbon, rest atom. Slag, top gas. Okay, so slag is nil because flux we are not adding anything. Top gas, it is CO, CO2 and N2. THM refers to 1 ton hot metal liquid pig iron. Atomic weights are given. Okay, the total amount of oxygen in CO and CO2 living with the top gas each. Okay, so there is a trick and also logic how you proceed this one, right? So for this is a material balance question. So for this we know there is a process. You can mark it in a square box. So this tells you this process, and there is input in the left hand side and there is output in the right hand side. In the input part, these are my input. In the output part, these are my output. Okay, so I will tell you, like, you write it down so that it will be easy. Okay, so here that means Fe2O3 is added, and this is added at 1357. Okay, I'm not writing it full. Okay, let me write it full. Fe2O3 1357 kg per THM, then carbon 400 kg per THM, O2 and N2, O2 293 kg per THM, 964 kg per THM. What is the output? Hot metal. It contains 58% carbon, rest iron, and CO, CO2 and N2. Okay guys, see, what is the amount? First question is question number 52. Let us solve. I'm writing just over here so that you can relate it also. Okay, or should I make it slightly smaller? Okay guys, okay, so see, the amount of oxygen in CO and CO2 living with the top gas. See, what is the exit one? It is CO and CO2. Is there any oxygen, other oxygen present? No. That means the all oxygen which is going in the input will be consumed to form your CO and CO2, right? So what are the input oxygen which we have? We have direct oxygen which we are putting, right? So it is 293 kg, and all calculation is to be done for 1 ton hot metal. 293 kg plus, and from where we are putting oxygen, you see, in the input side, see, nitrogen So it is nitrogen, there is no oxygen, carbon, then Fe2O3. See, there is oxygen in Fe2O3. So what is this amount of oxygen? It will be, so we will do this molecular balance, so like Fe2 and O3, right? So it will be like oxygen, it contains molecular mass 16, so it will be 16 into 3 divided by 16 into 3 plus iron, it is 56 into 2. Okay, you can see the molecular mass into, what is the total quantity of Fe2O3? It is 1357. Okay, so now do this calculation. So if you do this calculation, so it will be 700.1 kg. Okay, right everyone, so this is the amount of oxygen which we are putting. So this is the also the amount of oxygen which will be leaving, right? So that's why the amount of oxygen in CO and CO2 leaving with the top gas will be equal to 700 kg. That is option C. Okay, fine, till now it is fine. I think all of you must have done this. The next question, and that is important question, the CO by CO2 molar ratio in the top gases. Okay, so what is the amount of CO and CO2 in the moles? Means what is the moles of CO and what is the mole of CO2 which is living with the top gas? Okay, now guys, see, in the input we have carbon, oxygen, nitrogen and Fe2O3, right? See, when we form this CO and CO2, that means the reaction will be, the carbon is going to react with oxygen to form this CO and as well as this CO2, right? So how will be the reaction? So reaction will be like, see, I am solving from here, 53, see, carbon, okay, carbon, it will react with half of oxygen to form your CO in the first case. Okay, let us see the second case. Carbon, it will react with one mole of oxygen to form your CO2. This is one chance. Okay, now guys, what is the amount of carbon which is available for the reaction? See, in the input side we are putting 400 kg of carbon, and if you see in the output side, the 58% of carbon is there in the hot metal, right? That means the 5%, see, 5% means 5% of total hot metal it contains, right? So the total hot metal, it is 1 ton. So 5% of 1 ton will be, let us find here, so 5% of 1 ton, 1000 kg. So 50 kg is containing carbon in hot metal, right? So the left carbon is equal to 400 in the input side and 50 it was in the output, right? Means which was unreacted. That is your 350 kg. That means the 350 kg of carbon is going to do the reaction with oxygen to form this. Okay, and whatever the oxygen which will be, that will be the total oxygen, and total oxygen we have calculated, it is 700 kg. Okay, now see, we have this 350 kg of carbon, right? So what is the mole of carbon, total mole of carbon which we have? So mole of carbon will be 350 by 12. So how much it is? It is 29.16. okay, so see here, initially we have 29.16, right? Now suppose for the first reaction, x mole of carbon reacts with your half mole of oxygen, right? X mole, suppose let us consider this one as x mole. Okay, now see, x mole of this reacts, So it will react with x by 2 mole of O2 to give your x mole of CO. No issue. Now, since x mole has been reacted, so in the next equation it will be left with 29.16 minus x mole of carbon. So this 29.16 minus x will react with 29.16 minus x to give 29.16 minus x mole of CO2. Okay. Now guys, we know the total amount of oxygen which we have. It is 700 kg, right? So what is this mole of oxygen? It will be, so 700 divided by this molecular mass, so it will be 16 into 2. So it will be, wait, I have done the calculation. Okay, so see here it is x by 2 mole and here it is 29.16 minus x mole of oxygen. So if you add these two, so it should be 21.87, right everyone? So let us add this one. So x by 2 plus 29.16 minus x is equal to 21.87. So now if you find this, okay, so from here you will calculate, then x will be 14.58. okay, 14.58, right? So guys, now we need to find this PCO by PCO2. So it will be, CO will be x, x is your 14.58 divided by CO2. CO2 is your 29.16 minus 14.58. So if you do this calculation, so it will come equal to 1. Okay, so this is how it has been calculated. Okay, so this is it. So hope this will help you for your GATE preparation. Thank you.